On Donny van der Beek, do you know how long he's likely to be out for?
Not yet. So we are still doing investigations, and in a moment, it's a knee injury, and in a moment we have it clear. We will bring that.
Is Marshall okay for tomorrow?
Yes, he's fit and he's available.
And just finally for me, with Butland, is he going to be your number two, or do you regard Tom Heaton as the number two?
I never work like that. We have now three goalkeepers, they're all experienced, and they all can be 1, 2, 3, but it's quite clear, David in this moment, it's about his a long way, of course, in Manchester United, is clear the number one. I think Tom, he was many times on the bench. He had bad luck when he was injured for the Carabao Cup, the first one against Aston Villa. Then Martin was keeping and did very well. Now the situation, Jack Butland coming in. Now we have to see. I have to see his performance in training. The Carabao Cup is coming quick, and then we will make a choice. Tom is, of course, he's more adept to our way of play. He's more connection with the dressing room, with the team. But still, I have to make a decision to Tuesday. But first, I think on tomorrow. So for me, it's in this moment, no issue.
Neil, Eric, you often after good wins like Tuesday say what the team hasn't done. How much more do you think can come from this team this season?
Well, I think in a lot of aspects there's room for space for improvement, and it's about in a lot of aspects when you can get the improvement, obviously your process is better, your way of play is better, and when that's better, the opportunity you win games is higher. And that is what we have to work for.
And just with Marcus, you mentioned earlier about if he's in the game 100%, is that what you think is slightly missing? Sometimes he can wander out the game and an opportunity can go.
I was really happy with his goal, 3-0 against Bournemouth. So then he stayed in the game. He didn't score in that game, but still he was focused, and on the right moment, on the right spot, he was there to make his goal in that game. I said to him from the first moment, you will create chances, or the team will create chances for you when you are in the right moment and the right spot. Welcome. Every game, but it can be first minute, can also be the 95 minute. So make sure you are there, and then you have the skills to finish with right, with left, with his head, doesn't matter what.
James, and then
Eric, you're obviously down an attacking option at the moment with Jaden not being available to play. He's obviously back at Carrington. You obviously have been clear you would ideally like to strengthen your attack still further. Is it going to increase the pressure on Jaden to come back into the fold and give you that extra attacking option? When do you really need him to come back, and when do you see that happening?
Oh, I would like it to have Jaden as soon as possible back. But also in this, I can't force this process, and so I will do everything what's in my power. Some processes you can't force, and this is one of them. So I have also to show patience, although I don't have the patience, because you are right, we have a lack of opportunities in the front line. I have players who are available, of are capable to contribute in the Premier League, not only Premier League, but on the highest standard in top football. And Jaden is one. When he is fit, he will contribute, and then we have an extra option, and so we have more chance to winning a lot of games.
And now he's back at Carrington. Have you been able to speak to him, and what do you see the hurdles or the issues that he's still got to cross?
We have some hurdles to take, but I think he is in a good direction. And what I say, I can't force this process, so I don't do. But So I would be really happy in the moment he's really turning in the squad for team training. So that will be the next step.
He's not actually injured, is he? He's just not fit enough, you don't think?
In this moment, he's not fit enough, no.
And you said, you mentioned a mental aspect in the past that you think there might be a problem.
I said physical, and but the physical is also often a connection with mental. I think he's now making good progress on the physical part, so and that will help him. And I think, I hope he can return quickly, but I can't say termination of a duration, how long it will be.
Dave, and then the last question, Chris.
Eric, it's 6 years since Manchester United last won a trophy. I think you won the Dutch Cup before you won the title there, and obviously Sir Alex Ferguson, his first trophy here was the FA Cup before all of his success. How important can a trophy be in terms of being a launch pad for more success, and how important would it be to get that first trophy here?
So we have a lot of opportunities to win a trophy. We are still in many competitions, and to winning a trophy is something great. Every trophy to win is great, and it will give you an experience what can help you to win more titles or more trophies, and maybe also bigger trophies. That's definitely true. And so first you have to go over that limit to get that experience, because it's always the same players always winning trophies, and that's not a coincidence. And because it has to do, of course, with his capabilities and often with mentality.
You're confident this team, this squad is capable of winning trophies?
Oh yeah, I think we have some players in this team who have the experience and who can help us.
Last question, Chris.
Eric, just one more on Jaden there. If you can't say when he's due back, can you say whether you feel, from what you've seen and heard so far, he's felt the benefit of his time in Holland? And do you think that physically and mentally, you know, that he is showing signs of improvement now?
No, it's not. So he was in the Netherlands, but also the process could also could have been in England as well. But the cool thing is, and that's that he's back in Carrington, and that show he's making progress. So he's ready for the next step.
A sort of £75 million forward at Manchester United, with all the facilities you have, all the experts, become unfit? How could that be allowed to happen?
But I think, many in top athleticism, in top, and so also in football, but also in different other sport arts, sometimes it's good to go away from the place where you are daily at, and to get a new vibe, to get and spirit, and where people have a different approach, and that can give you the right push to get back on track.
But if you had 20 Jadon Sanchos who were all unfit, you'd be snookered, wouldn't you? You know, you'd be in trouble. So how could he? You know, I'm wondering why or how did he become unfit in the first place? If kind of the club's job, your job, the physics job is to keep these players tip top.
Oh, football are not robots, football players, and no one is the same. And I think for everyone, you need an individual approach. And yeah, we thought, in cooperation with Jaden, it was the best choice.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you.